At Holiday Inn Express, we take care of what matters inside the hotel so you can enjoy what matters outside of it.
You don't need mascot mayhem to enjoy half time.
Here we go.
You just need the unbelievable taste of Domino's.
Nice one.
Order now for half time.
On January the 31st, the transfer window will close.
Join Jim, me and the whole team for all the transfer deadline day news on Sky Sports News HQ.
Ladbrokes, backing the SPFL on Sky Sports.
Welcome back to Fir Park in Motherwell, where, as you can probably see there, it's snowing. The Rangers supporters in the away end here today. It's their first visit for a league game here for 5 years, when a local lad, Lee McCulloch, scored the winner for Rangers. And there's the Motherwell supporters wrapped up against the weather today. Well, last week they thought their heroes were on the verge of knocking Rangers out of the Scottish Cup until Kenny Miller popped up. The old fella, Kenny Miller, not as old as them, but it's good to see they've come out in matching hats there. Neil McCann and Billy Davis join me there. This is going to be a big encounter, isn't it, for Rangers and their bid to get second place back?
This will be a tough game. We've already mentioned their away form being pretty poor. And against a Motherwell side who will be smarting from last week, I believe Motherwell could give Rangers all types of problems today with McDonald and Moult restored to the front pairing. And Tavernier, although he doesn't maybe at times want to do it, has to defend. He has to come in and help his two centre-backs, David.
OK, more from Billy and from Neil at half-time. The commentators for this one are the former Motherwell favourite, Andy Walker, and everybody's favourite commentator, Ian Crocker.
Not sure about that. Thank you, David. Well, these two teams meet again for the second Saturday running, but the venue has changed. Motherwell were so close to knocking Rangers out of the cup at Ibrox. So close, yet so far, as Kenny Miller dug Rangers out of a rather huge hole. Motherwell make just one change from the Scottish Cup meeting between the sides last week. Scott McDonald is in from the off this time. Keith Lasley makes way. McDonald has a decent recent record against Rangers on the goal front. Louis Moult scored at Ibrox last week to make it 12 goals and counting for him this season. Joe Chalmers made his return last week after 4 months out. He keeps his place. Lee Lucas is still suspended. Rangers make two changes. There's a first start for the American Emerson Hyman on loan from Bournemouth. Jason Holt makes way. James Tavernier, suspended in the Scottish Cup, replaces Lee Hodgson. Michael O'Halloran, linked with Motherwell and others, keeps his place. Kenny Miller kept Rangers in the Cup last week, but then he has a decent recent record against Motherwell. There are three new arrivals on the home bench. Keeper Russell Griffiths on loan from Everton, Zach Tewell's on loan from Reading, and winger Elliot Freer signed from Forest Green Rovers. Jason Holt drops to the Rangers bench. Mark McGee's Motherwell have a score to settle here, but both teams know exactly what to expect as they meet for second Saturday running. Kickoff is next.
Comes the corner, cleared away at the near post. He could have a crack here. Good effort. Here comes the corner, cleared away at the near post. He could have a crack here. Sensational!
Great. Just got greater. Turbocharge your winnings with a chance of cash bonuses when you cash out any bet with all new Cash Out Boost. Why cash out anywhere else? Sky Bet. That's betting better.
Well, Rangers were shifted out of second place by Aberdeen last night. Motherwell are ninth. 4 points off the relegation playoff position, 5 off the bottom. That's a little bit too close for comfort. Willie Collum is the referee. He gets us going. Motherwell need a pick-me-up after blowing it big time at Ibrox in the Cup. A victory over the same opponents today would certainly do the trick, Andy.
Yeah, I think like last week game we'll get a really close game, a lot of good football. It'll be interesting to see how the Rangers line up with the likes of Terrell, Halliday and Hyman in midfield, a new look three there. And of course you've always got that threat from Motherwell with Moult and McDonald back in the side.
Here's Clint Hill. Emerson Hyman. Now Lee Wallace. Andy Halliday. James Tavernier. Ban for the cup encounter. For yellow cards accrued in the competition last season. Halliday. Here's Barry Mackay. More than capable of making things happen for Rangers, although not just yet. Clint Hill, 38 now, but he's been a top pro who's looked after himself. And of the old boys that Rangers brought in this season, he's been by far and away the standout. Richard Tate closed in on him. Tate, a new arrival this season, came from Grimsby, whom he helped into the Football League last season. Craig Clay midfield made the same journey north. Stevie Hamill steers that back to Craig Sampson. Motherwell beat Rangers twice in the 2015 playoff. Those are their only wins in their last 44 encounters with Rangers. Tate, McDonald. Here's Cadden. Tate's cross, McDonald helps it on. Scooped away by Kiernan. McHugh. Terrell has moved ahead of him. Tavernier for O'Halloran. Tavernier away by Hennigan. Here's Halliday. Craig Clay for McDonald. Scott McDonald. Sort to go for goal himself, even though Chalmers was available.
Yeah, it just shows you how hard these Motherwell players work. That was Louis Moult, who won the ball just outside his own box, setting McDonald and Cadden away.
The playing surface here in Firth Park this season is an absolute dream. The rain and the snow make it zip around as Chalmers crosses. Tate could yet keep this alive. He has kept it in. Kiernan. Chalmers ready to send it back, but it's cleared by Hyman. Returned by Hamill. Met by Hill. Ooh, and O'Halloran has caught McHugh here with a high one, and the Motherwell players are raging, and Willie Collum has a call to make here, and it's going to be a red card for Michael O'Halloran. With just 4 minutes played, Rangers down to 10 men.
Well, I'm not surprised he's gone because it's so high. The only thing that surprises me, Ian, is it's out of character for Michael O'Halloran. But I think when he sees this back, he'll see how high he was. The Motherwell players absolutely furious with that challenge. So early in the game. You can see here, it's a poor touch, but look how high he is. He opens his foot out so that all of the studs are going into the body here. Carl McHugh is in trouble. This is a really sore one to take. Willie Collum had the perfect view of it. I think he took a couple of seconds just to make up his mind. But you can't get away with that, Ian. It's a stupid challenge. It's reckless. It's dangerous. No thought given to what that means to your opponent. Hopefully he will make a good recovery, but you can't blame Willie Collum for showing a red card so early.
I don't think Mark Warburton or David Weir will be complaining too much. It was a dreadful challenge from Michael O'Halloran, and certainly out of character, but that's not really an excuse in the circumstances. Thankfully, Carl McHugh is back on his feet, but McGee's Motherwell have a man advantage already. James McFadden working alongside McGee. Well, what a start at Fir Park. Halloran sent off. A free kick for Motherwell. Veteran and captain today, Stevie Hemel, will float this one in. Louis Malt's header is offside anyway. Flag is up.
Well, this is going to be a tall order now for Rangers in the pursuit of Aberdeen for the runners-up spot. But a big game for Motherwell, you've got to say, Ian. See Cadden on the right-hand side, he's furious, he didn't get a pass here. Rangers guilty of overplay. Halliday getting caught in possession. When you get that much of the goal to Amar, surely you at least want the goalkeeper.
Craig Clay has become a prominent member of this Motherwell side. Michael O'Halloran have waited so long to get into this Rangers team as well, to have a chance to show what he can do from the off. This is offside again against Malt. Willie Collum left with absolutely no choice on this red card.
Well, Willie Collum has been known to show a dubious red card or two. I don't think there's any dubiety here. It's just so dangerous. No regard for his opponent there. And thankfully, he's okay.
First red card of Halloran's career.
And a great pity for him too, because he's not had a lot of game time. Got in from the start last week and kept his spot today.
Rangers a little sloppy in losing possession at the moment. McDonald's cross. Tavernier away, but only to Clay. Now Chalmers. Motherwell putting the pressure on here. And they have a corner. Motherwell took the lead at Ibrox in the cup and in the league, but still ended up losing on both occasions. And Rangers won 2-0 here in the League Cup back in July in the first game of the campaign. In the sleet and the snow, it's a corner for Tate to deliver, comfortably cleared by Terrell.
Poor delivery, he's got so many teammates up there in and around that six-yard box. Them a chance to go and attack it.
Joe Chalmers, former Celtic rookie, finds Craig Clay. There was some Hyman in there for Rangers, and it's gone out for a Rangers throw. Take Motherwell on the front foot against the 10 men. Fotheringham made a decision to come. Wallace. Terrell. Miller. Mackay. Skipping away from McManus. Now up against Hamill. Weaving his way around the field. Terrell for Tavernier. Now a corner for Rangers as they answer back.
Excellent for Mackay, kept hold of the ball really well there under a bit of pressure.
Emerson Hyman, who came through Fulham's youth system before joining Bournemouth, will take this corner. His time, who can he pick out here? Just Cadden is the answer. Tavernier, Malt, Rangers rather short at the back now as Cadden latches onto this from McDonald. Cadden's cross, McDonald stretching nearly, but not quite.
Brilliant teasing ball from Cadden here, He's faced up with Wallace. He doesn't even have to look into the box. I think he realises that Scott McDonald or Moult will be there. He's just half a yard or so, just a bit heavy.
It looks like we have a game on here, even though Rangers have lost a man already. Screaming at his teammates. Still going strong. 37, very strong. Hamill. Kiernan stepped in front of Maltz. Wow, Kiernan has slid in there. Willie Collum. Will summon Kiernan to him. It's going to be a yellow card.
It's a stupid challenge, especially given the circumstances. On the stretch there, again with the stud showing. It's only the 1 foot that's up there, but goodness, I think Hamill read it so well. He was athletic enough to jump and get out of the way there. Stupid challenge from Kiernan. I think most referees even will take into account the conditions. It's a very fast pitch today, it's very slick. No complaints about the O'Halloran red card. I think Kiernan's lucky there.
Towards Hennigan, won by Clint Hill, struck well by McHugh. But a routine stop really for Wes Fotheringham.
Well, he had to take it cleanly. McDonald was in looking for any sort of rebound. Now in terms of closing Rangers down in that attacking third, not letting them play it out as easily, forcing them to go long, making goals 50-50, he should retain more possession.
McDonald will latch onto that, knocked out of the air by Fotheringham.
Well, an immediate hand of apology from Tavernier. So sloppy in that pass there, McDonald onto it in a flash, and even although it's on his left side, he gets a decent shot away.
Tavernier got away with that one. Clint Hill gets a second chance to clear. Toral. Moved away from McHugh. Now Wallace. He's offside.
I think he's brought it back, Ian, just for he didn't have secure possession there. Willie Collum just giving them a free kick for the foul on Toral.
Throughout, Heinemann, Mackay, eventually finds Wallace. There's a few waiting for the cross. Hennigan met it first. Miller. It's off Terrell in the end for a goal kick.
Kenny Miller holding around the edge of the box here. I mean, the ball breaks to him. Another one who's quite happy to have a pop on his left side. Doesn't catch it as well as he would have liked.
He's only managed one win in 15 games as a manager against Rangers. That was in his time at Aberdeen, although he couldn't have come much closer than last week. 1-0 off at Ibrox in the cup with 6 minutes left. Enter Kenny Miller. Captain. Hill fending off McDonald. Wallace now for Toral. Hennigan. Top by Louis Holt and duly dispatched by Kiernan. So an early setback for Mark Warburton in what was always going to be a testing trip to Fir Park. Stevie Hamill. Sorry. cue. Picking out Tate. Helped on first time, but Fotheringham is having that.
Well, he's doing well, Tate, as a right back, getting forward, as you would expect him to do with a man advantage.
Hamill. Clay. Mott. Who made that mistake last week to gift Kenny Miller the winner, though Kenny still had a bit to do. Cannon. Hennigan. Clay. Cannon. Tate. McDonald in front of Hill. Cannon. Tate, it's blocked by Clint Hill, but it's a corner to further encourage Motherwell.
Yeah, really good play from Motherwell, very patient, lovely ball into the box for McDonald, couldn't quite get the layoff, but dominating possession as you would expect.
And that's the Hennigan joining Louis Moulton there. Wait! Chalmers with the corner, bounced off Miller. Wait! But awkwardly cleared by Hill. Chalmers ready to return it here. Miller. Players wearing black armbands after the death of former player Billy Simpson this week. He was 87. Kinnan. Tavernier. Heineman. Terrell for Mackay. Terrell, who came through Barcelona's youth system and then joined Arsenal. There are worse places to learn your trade. Hill. Terrell. Barry Mackay. Not too much on that from Clint Hill for Lee Wallace.
No, there's a surprising start there, Ian. Just the last 10 minutes, Rangers dominating the ball. I think you'll find Motherwell have got to be more ambitious with a man advantage. They're at home. Got to remember, although they're 3 points off the top six, Ian, they're still only five away from that foot of the table. They fancy their chances of getting all three today.
Yes, they don't quite know whether to look up or down at the moment. Richard Tate.
Quite admire the ambition there of Lee Wallace. He's playing like a left winger, down to 10 men, but he knows he's got to get forward from time to time.
Okay. Over towards Miller, won by Hamill. Tavernier doing battle with Chalmers, coming out of it rather well. For Hennigan, though. Hamill. McDonald. Malt. Scott McDonald. Worth a try, I guess. He certainly thought so.
Yeah, a bit frustrating for Tate here. You can see when McDonald wins it in the middle of the park, driving forward. Tate was on the overlap. McDonald having a proper goal, just loses control of the shot.
Whilst Scott McDonald was doing that, Joe Chalmers was spilling blood for the cause. Presumably got caught by Tavernier in that incident a moment ago, but looks like that will take some stemming.
Yeah, Tavernier just went over there and just offered a bit of an apology. Just that flailing arm. Absolutely no intent whatsoever.
Kenny Miller and David Weir deep in conversation. Joe Chalmers is attended to, so both teams down to 10 at the moment. Kiernan, Miller, Mackay, Barry Mackay, couldn't find a way past Ben Hennigan. Kiernan won his duel with Malt, but it ends up with Richard Tate. Now Cadden, Wallace's way up the field, Cadden's cross! Scott McDonald unable to stick it away, and it was on, it was on.
Can't believe he missed it. Tried to stay on his feet and get a solid first touch. It's a perfect run from McDonald. Just throw your body at it. Get a bigger target. You're only, what, 2-3 yards from goal. It's amazing that he got a touch, and it's still not enough to get it in the back of the net. And doesn't he know it?
Scored in his last two league games against Rangers and 5 in the last 7. That should have been another one for Scott McDonald, but it stays goalless.
Well, you mentioned it, Ian. It was Lee Wallace who was charging down the goalkeeper Sampson at the other end. Motherwell taking advantage of him out of position.
So Chalmers still receiving treatment for Motherwell. Hill. Holiday. Spain in the first half of this season. Must have got bored with the weather. Here's Wallace. Kenny Miller. Richard Tate to clear. Joe Chalmers won't be returning, so Motherwell are going to have to make a change. Lee Wallace. Hyman. Halliday. Terrell. Jack McMillan will be coming on for Joe Chalmers shortly. Hyman, perfect pass for Miller. Now Tavernier. Nobody to aim for in the box yet. Now they've arrived. Screened by McManus. Mackay. Halliday. Mackay. Hyman. Plenty of room here for Halliday. Kiernan. Thank you. Miller, closely watched by Hennigan. Mackay. Miller, lovely ball through for Mackay. With enough bodies around.
Good football from Rangers, very patient, knocked it about really well, waiting for the opening.
And Scott McDonald has caught Kenny Miller here. And it's going to be a red card for Scott McDonald, would you believe? And now both teams are down to 10 men as McDonald walks.
David Weir and James McFadden having notes on the bench here. Scott McDonald can't believe it. He took a heavy touch. And then with Kenny Miller, it became a 50-50. Amazing that before the half hour, we've got a 10-10. Miller just jostling. There's a 50-50. He gets, looks as though he gets the ball, McDonald. But then his follow through is certainly onto the instep. The ankle of Kenny Miller. And again, you can't blame Willie Collum if he's seen that foot so high over the ball, catching the opponent right on the ankle. That's a sore one for Miller. I think it's entirely justified, yet another red card.
Yeah, no option again really for Willie Collum. Michael O'Halloran sent off after just 4 minutes. And Scott McDonald for Motherwell. Motherwell, it's all happening here at the moment. Joe Chalmers' bloody nose hasn't stopped bleeding, so he's had to go off to be replaced by Jack McMillan, one of a few players who won the Scottish Youth Cup for Motherwell last season, who've broken into the first team. Mark McGee's man advantage has gone, and a key man for him as well in Scott McDonald. Motherwell might miss him more than Rangers would miss O'Halloran, perhaps.
Must be a painkiller. On to Kenny Miller there. Thankfully, it looks as though he's okay. I think when you saw how high McDonald was, I think you can understand the action that Willie Collum took there.
Joe Chalmers came over after that knock he took from Tavernier. McHugh. Cadden. Tate. It's 10 against 10. Kenny Miller has returned. Halliday, Terrell, Kinnan, straight pass for Tavernier, who just edged forward.
He's going through, he's used to the ball a couple of times now, he's been heavy, wayward.
Two red cards, but no goals yet. It's been a lively half hour one way or another. Hamill. Ooh, mistake from Stevie Hamill. Miller pounced. Terrell. Hyman. Simpson makes the save. And Tate is able to complete the clearance.
Well, he saved it well, but there was so much pace on it. Hennigan did well to get out of the way. It could easily have been an own goal. As Samson made that save, Hennigan didn't really know where that ball was going.
Clint Hill. Barry Mackay takes over. Hyman. Terrell. Louis Malt having a nibble. Tavernier. Confronted by McMillan. It's come to Lee Wallace. Skidded off Craig Clay for a corner.
Yeah, Clay facing him up there. Wallace having a perfect goal from outside the box.
The young American, Emerson Hyman, is on corner kick duties. Hyman towards Miller. Collected by Sampson. Has McMillan nearby. Here's McHugh. Hennigan. Mackay. Happy to take them on here, Barry Mackay. And McManus timed that right.
Well, it's tremendous attacking and defending, isn't it? For Mackay, just a drive from the middle of the park into the box, but McManus using all of the experience to get in that vital challenge.
Wallace was fancying a short corner, but Motherwell soon prevented that. He'll be going straight in by the look of it, although Kenny Miller just sipped across there. Hyman. For another corner.
Did well to work a yard or two to get the shot away, Hyman.
Hyman's first start for Rangers. Came on as a sub against Motherwell last week. Terrell. Louis Malt clears. Tavernier. Miller. Mackay. Mackay looking for Terrell, and it was taken away by Tate.
Tate over on the left-hand side there did well. Slightly the ball. Could have been difficult for him.
Halliday, Tavernier, Hyman. Lee Wallace ready to smack it goalwards. And it's another corner.
Two or three Motherwell players just throwing themselves in the way. With a shot from Lee Wallace, again just taking up that position just outside the box.
Series of corners for Rangers, can they make one count? Tavernier will take this one for a change. Tate and McMillan are on the posts. Terrell, closely monitored. Wallace. Mackay. Terrell, the furthest man forward. Kiernan. Clint Hill. Terrell. Halliday. Kiernan. Terrell. Kenny Miller. Perhaps an opening here for Rangers. Miller for Wallace. On his right foot, he tried it. Craig Clay. Hamill has young Jackman Millen ahead, and also Louis Maltus peeled away to that touchline. Lovely touch from Malt for McMillan here. Cadden through the middle. Tate is the man he'll try and pick out, but Wallace able to clip. Kenny Miller has given it back to Tate. McHugh. Hamill. Cadden rushing across. Clint Hill. Likewise. Firm but fair.
Yeah, exactly that. You put him on the track there. 50-50 to be won. Don't think there's any complaints from Cadden. Hill wins the ball. Conditions help him take the man onto the track.
Hamill. Shamble West Fodringham.
It was a really good kick out from Fotheringham, who spotted that diagonal run from Mackay. Just a bit unlucky. We're now a plate.
Malt, Cadden. Clay and McMillan are in the box. Malt's getting there. Cadden going for glory, which was perhaps the wrong option.
Yeah, not his best attempt, but I think he would always fancy his chances 1v1 against Clint Hill. He's such a strong runner, very direct. No surprise he's having a proper goal. Having a really good season, Cadden. No, that's since Scott McDonald's gone off the last 10 minutes. Rangers again dominant in possession. So much room for everyone now. 10v10. Can't see this game being scoreless at the end of 90 minutes.
Mackay. Terrell. Heinemann. Kenny Miller waiting to receive. Miller for Heinemann. It's Miller! Samson forced into another reasonable save. And Hill made sure he was going to win that. Play. Tate. Stevie Hamill will be the next port of call here from Carl McHugh. McMillan ahead. McHugh. Tidy pass for Hamill. McMillan. McHugh.
Well, that pass not a good one. The earlier one out wide, the first time from Carl McHugh. Perfect. Motherwell couldn't take advantage of it though.
Tate. McKinnon. Hamill. Malt.
Good play from Malt. He'll be the focal point of the attack now. Everyone else trying to get up in support of him. His touch has to be really secure.
Cannon. Clay. And a really hefty pass. McMillan was the intended target.
Well, Kenny Miller looking lively, linking up with Hyman here. Just getting a quick 1-2. Craig Sampson alive and alert to it. Didn't want to take any chances. To try and take it cleanly, just got the angle to push it away.
Kane, Halliday, Terrell. The minute already gone. Clay, McMillan to his left, Cannon to the right. Here's McHugh. Malt. Louis Malt again. Richard Tate in round the back. Seemed to delay, and then it went out for a goal kick.
Well, I thought the weight on it from Malt was perfect. A really difficult ball to find Richard Tate here. He doesn't take it there. Lets it bounce one more time, and it's too much.
Hill. Guy rode the challenge from Hennigan. Hyndman. Beautifully floated to Kenny Miller, and Hennigan in the way.
That was a chance for Miller. Had he gotten up away from Hennigan there, clear pocket goal.
Thank you for Hamill. Motherwell still to have a go here. After a positive spell from Rangers. Hugh. Hennigan. Tate. Hamill. McMillan. Malt. Clint Hill tracking him. Malt made room for the cross, but Kinnan clears only as far as Hamill. McMillan. Malt moving away from Hill and then ran into Tavernier.
Well, he's working really hard off the ball, Malt, and as soon as he goes out wide, it gives the likes of Cadden and Clay the chance to get inside the box here. He's looking for a foul there. Quite right, not getting one.
We're back tomorrow with more action from the Scottish Premiership as Celtic host Hearts. It's from 12:30 on Sky Sports 1 and Sky Sports 5. Terrell. McHugh. Terrific.
Excellent from McHugh. Terrell desperate to get a shot away there. McHugh is a match for him.
Straight touch from Wallace. It's found a way to Tate. Malt. There will be 2 minutes of stoppage time at the end of this first half. McManus. Samson towards Malt. Shot by Clint Hill on Malt. We'll give Motherwell a chance late in the half.
Again, Malt did really well. Just put the brakes on. As soon as the brakes come on, two hands go into the back and Malt goes down. That's the way to win a foul.
Motherwell finish with a flourish in this first half. Stevie Hamill to deliver. Malt will help it on. Easy for Fodderingham. Still a minute left in stoppage time. Cadden covering. Clay. McHugh. Hamill. Millen, beaten to it by Keenan. Anders have had a few straight passes, but Halliday has rescued his own there. Here's Terrell for Miller. He can't pick out Mackay.
Yeah, I think he's been slacked too often in possession, Andy Halliday.
Goal is at half time, but the major talking point. Well, Willie Collins not averse to a card or two, but he had little option but to show two red cards to Michael O'Halloran after 4 minutes, and then on 26 minutes to Scott McDonald. Both teams down to 10 at the break. Motherwell 0, Rangers 0.
Ladbrokes backing the SPFL on Sky Sports.
Is on next Saturday on Sky Sports.
With BetVictor's Golden Goal, you get a free weekly prediction to guess the game's first scorer and the minute it scored. You can win serious money. Okay, I've guessed the player, but what minute should I go for? Let's ask the Liverpool manager what he thinks, shall we?
Statistically, most of the goals are scored in the 45th and in the 90th minute. But actually, the average time for the first goal is the 31st minute. But this weekend, who knows? First goal wins.
Go to Wix.com to create your stunning website. It's easy. Your website, totally stunning, created by you. Visit Wix.com today.
UK's number one vitamins for men from Vitabiotics.
Bring tea for to the man, steak for the sun, wine for the woman who made the rain come. Seagulls sing your hearts away as wild sinners sin, the children play. Oh Lord, how they play.
Love quality pizza but want an amazing deal? Well, Papa John's give you both, because right now all our pizzas are half price. That's 50% off every pizza every day. And with Papa's quality guarantee, you get the quality and price Papa John's deliver every time.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
That moment when time stands still and you wish you never had to grow up. Thompson, discover your smile. Adult Protected.
As capable as a dog sled. as agile as a hoverboard. Don't know what the country is. As comfortable as a carriage. But in Rome,
beautiful horses.
From Standard.
On an evening in Roma, Sotercello de Roma.
Experian know life is full of important steps. And now, Experian Credit Matcher helps you take a next step towards financial control. First, get your Experian credit score free forever. Then use Credit Matcher to find credit cards and loans you're more likely to be accepted for. Take the guesswork out of searching for credit cards and loans at experian.co.uk.
Churchy, I really don't have time for this.
Oh, no.
I should be meeting that 4x4 up the road. Here he comes. What a dreamboat.
Oh,
Churchill offers new motor customers free breakdown cover.
Oh, yes.
Thanks, Churchill.
Churchill, depend on the dog.
Check your pockets. Check for love. Check the milk. Check for love again. Check your laces. Check your horoscope. Check for life. Get a reality check. Check for monsters. Get a full checkup. Check your numbers. Check the damage. Check you out. The world belongs to those who check, and we compare more financial products than any other comparison site. So you haven't checked until you've checked with money.co.uk.
Presenting the Country Cottage range from Oak Furniture Land. Our January sale ends this Sunday. Onward.
Ladbrokes, backing the SPFL on Sky Sports.
Well, they call him as regularly at the target for the cheap shop merchants, but did he get absolutely spot on today?
Yeah, I don't think you can have any arguments with either red card. At first, I did have an argument because I'm thinking, oh no, he's going for the ball. But see, when you see that, I knew it was a horrible challenge, but I just thought he nicked the ball. He didn't get any of the ball. And when you go high, it's so dangerous. Very lucky that he comes away from that standing up, to be honest. Because it's so naughty, isn't it, Billy?
Yeah, very much so. And, you know, obviously, you wouldn't expect that type of challenge from this type of player. But it's clumsy. Oof. It's extremely dangerous. And there's no doubt the referee got it spot on.
Can you find any defence for Scott McDonald?
He's taken his eye off the ball. And he's taken a heavy touch. But no, this is absolutely a red card all day long as well. And he actually protests more than O'Halloran did. But it's the sole of the boot. You can't go in, watch it here, watch the sole of the boot got bang there, right onto the shin, and there's a little bit of delay on the leg. He's not recoiling his leg. Look at that there, bang. And that could have been a leg breaker. So for me, two spot on decisions. You can see Willie Collins' view right through there. You can see the fourth official just above McDonald where it's written. Both of them have a perfect view. Billy?
Yeah, absolutely. I think you can talk all day long about refereeing decisions in the past and how many reds and yellows they've given, David, but on this occasion, you've got to say this referee today got it absolutely spot on with the two reds.
Well, his 64th red card in the last 10 years, just a 31 more than the other referee. But he's brave and he got it absolutely bang on. Well done, Willie Colm. Now, I suppose the big problem for Motherwell was that they were doing well when they had the numerical advantage. Where in the pitch did it show most?
Well, it's affected Cadden, because now when you're getting into wide positions, originally he's getting into wide positions, he's got two targets. Spoke about it before the game and how McDonald's relationship with Moult affects the two centre-backs. Helps deep, he's trying to get work back in, he can't get near that. That is an unbelievably good ball, shaped in. He works Wallace back, he gets him slightly off-balance and then he delivers, and this is all about putting it in a great area again. And McDonald thinks he should go with that with his left foot, David, instead of his right, as it's coming along. He's been red-carded, and suddenly his options are limited, Billy, and he's taking wrong decisions because he's getting nobody to hit.
Neil, let's not be kiddied here. Out of all the players in the Motherwell team that you don't want to lose, Scott McDonald's the one, because he's the one that's been taking balls into your feet. He's the one that's been linking play, and he's the one that's had a couple of good chances in the last 45 minutes. But there's absolutely no doubt that this player...